manuscript. My manager, Brian, he calls, he says, hey, Shawnee, you gotta read this, you gotta do this, it's great. And I read it, and I was so upset by the script. There was this jaw trap scene that they had made a short film, Lee and James did, in Australia. And that's how the movie got made, and Lee was in the jaw trap. So they wanted to put a girl in there, which I thought was pretty cool. So I said, it's a great script, but I don't want to live this out, even for a day. So I'm just gonna pass. And they came back. So finally they said, come in the office, we want to show you this short film. So I'm sitting at the conference table. You know, like six men sitting around me, showing me this movie. I looked around and suddenly came to my senses and thought, you know, this should ever happen again in your career. This is great, you have to say yes. And so then I said, of course I'll do it. Oh, God! And the great thing about Amanda is, like, she gets to kick ass, but she's also a woman of substance and depth, and she's struggling, and there's real drama. I see a lot of myself in her, the desire to build, the desire to serve something higher, and also the destructiveness. She was lost shooting heroin, but there was something in her that was still strong enough to fight.
We have one of the victims who managed to escape. Want to know if you wouldn't mind sticking around and listening to her testimony?
There's an amazing part about that interrogation scene that no one, including myself, expected or saw at the time. And that was this one line, he held me. And Saw 2 and Saw 3, kind of in a way, all came out of whatever substance there was in that one line, that one day.
Calm down. What's your name?
There was a stripping of her that happened between 1 and 2. Take away the drugs, take away the physicality, the cutting of the hair, the desexualizing, all the ways that she identified herself, she was willing to let go of.
Amanda, do not be afraid. Your life has just begun.
There was kind of like a commando monk, like, training. She devotes herself to her work and to this philosophy and completely gives herself over to it. In part 3, you can see the substance of what she's been building.
Amanda, it's time to start our game.
It's a love story in that way with her and John. They both are dedicated to this higher principle, and she's struggling because 95% of her can build the house and 5% tears it down. Think about building a house, right? How long it takes you to lay the foundation and then build it, and then one battering ram, one swing, you know, boom, it's gone. Part 3, I got to work with Tobin, which is just a whole other experience. Part 3 kind of hinges on believing their relationship and the history and that something's been built. So it was Tobin's and my job to create substance for that. Tobin and I just spent, you know, hours upon hours walking the streets of Toronto, just hanging out. We figured, you know, this is what John and Amanda would do, you know? We asked 1,000 questions, and then for every question we answered, there'd be 10 new questions, and Tobin has that kind of stamina for this kind of work, you know, this relentless search for truth.
If you fail in this, we all fail. Succeed, and we all succeed.
It's a lie! As a woman, I'm very endeared to her, and I'm hoping that, other women will, be endeared to her, and hopefully we can all learn something or be inspired in some positive way.